Hi guys, what's up? Welcome to Evershine Coaching Center and Shah Sir Classes. I am Shah Faisal Sir here. My dear friends, today I am going to continue the subject Social Science, our past one, the textbook in history for class 6. So today we are going to study the NCERT class 6 history. So this video can be utilized and it will be useful for those students who are present studying in class 6th grade and also the students who are facing for any competitive level exam. Okay, the one who wants to face the competitive level exam such as UPSC civil service exam. So for those students it will be very much helpful because class 6 to class 12 studying NCERT syllabus is very much important. Today we are going to study, as you can see here, this is chapter 1. Here, chapter 1 of Social Science. Without wasting much time, let me proceed further. As you can see here, chapter 1, what, where, how and when. As you can see the title, from the title itself we can able to understand what exactly we are studying here. What means nothing but, it's kind of a definition, right? What? Where? It's nothing but location. How? It's nothing but the thing which is coming under the action. And when? It's nothing but in which period of time it happened. So that is what we are just studying here. What, where, how and when. As you can see here, Rashida's question. Here, Rashida is nothing but they have taken as an example of one student. Rashida sat reading the newspaper. Suddenly her eyes fell on a small headline, 100 years ago. Okay, here you can see, well, while Rashida was reading the newspaper, suddenly her eyes fall on some headline of the newspaper. The title was 100 years ago. How? She wondered, could anyone know what happened so many years ago? As you can see, this is the question from the Rashida. आप देख सकते हैं रशीदा जब न्यूज़पेपर को पढ़ रहे थे तब उनको एक टाइटल दिखा जिसके अंदर लिखा था कि 100 इयर्स एगो. ओके, तो अचानक उनको ताजुब हुआ, अचानक उनको कि क्या हुआ था, क्या हो सकता है 100 इयर्स एगो. सो दैट इज व्हाट शी स्टार्टेड गेसिंग. ओके, शी वंडर्ड. नाउ लेट मी स्टडी व्हाट हैपेंड 100 इयर्स एगो. फाइंडिंग आउट व्हाट हैपेंड yesterday. Let me have a small story here. Let me learn this. Yesterday, you could listen to the radio. Okay, before we could go to the topic, what exactly we are studying in this chapter. Here they have given a small title to make you the given concept clear. Okay, you could listen to the radio, watch television, or read the newspaper. Right? This is actually, I hope you all might have done this. Right? I hope you have seen the TV. Aap TV dekhe honge ya कोई भी जगह पे जाकर आए होंगे या किसी जगह को आप देखे होंगे या कोई चीज सुने होंगे. एनीथिंग कुड बी पॉसिबल. यस्टरडे यू हैव डन दिस थिंग. नाउ लास्ट ईयर, कम बैक टू द वन मोर सिचुएशन. लास्ट ईयर, एक साल पहले, आस्क समबडी हु रिमेंबर्स. ओके, यू आस्क समबडी हु रिमेंबर्स, बट व्हाट अबाउट लॉन्ग लॉन्ग एगो. लेट अस सी हाउ इट कैन बी डन. सी चिल्ड्रन, वन डे बिफोर व्हाट हैपेंड. ओके, definitely you may tell at least 1 year ago. Okay, this is also possible that we can remember and we can tell what happened 1 year ago. But if the same question comes, what happened long 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 years ago, is it so easy to tell or to predict what happened? No, but still the answer is yes. Okay, now we can see here, what can we know about the past. What can we know about the past? Hum past ke bare mein kya jaan sakte. So what we can study about the past? Okay, there are several things we can find out. Okay, see children, past we should never forget because past will teach us how to live present and future life. So this title never you have to forget. Okay, so past is the only factor where we can stand so that we can uplift our life and also we can judge or we can rule. Anything can be done. Okay, as you can see here, there are several things we can find out. What people ate. Okay, it's kind of a story, right? It's the children. History is never a boring subject in case if you take those things as like a story and you are going to study. What people ate, the kind of clocks they wore, the houses in which they lived. We can find out about the lives of hunters, herders, farmers, rulers, merchants, priests, craftsmen, artists, musicians and scientists. Okay, so here what we can study about the past means we can study like what people ate, वो क्या खाए होंगे, किस तरह से वो रहते हैं, किस तरह से रहते होंगे, वो क्या कपड़े पहनते होंगे, वो किस तरह से उनका काम करते होंगे, तो ये सब चीजें हम देख सकते हैं. These all things we can study. Okay, we can also find out about the games children played, the stories they heard, the place they saw, the songs they sang. So even these all the things even we can just come to know. Okay, like how during that time, how were the children, what, how they were playing, what they played, what songs they were singing, all those things. As present, you can see in this situation, I mean in the present stage, you can see there are so many idol shows, we can say that there are so many different types of shows are there, like Indian Idol, etc. Right? So this is of present stage, but imagine what happened during that time, how those people were spending their time, right? It's something like interesting. I'm right? Yes. So that is what the history speaks. So from the past, we will collect this all information. Next, where did people live? So this is very, very, very important topic. Where did people live? This is the basic thing like what we have seen in the past. Okay. But here, this topic is very important for your examination point of view also. Okay. Now, as you can see here, where did people live? Okay. उस टाइम में, उस जमाने में, उस वक्त में जो लोग थे वो कहाँ रहते थे, कहाँ रहते होंगे, किस तरह से रहते थे, राइट? दैट इज व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी. वेयर डिड पीपल लिव? फाइंड द रिवर नर्मदा ऑन मैप. चिल्ड्रन, लाइक ऑफनली इफ यू सी द सेम प्लेस साइमल्टेनियसली, डेफिनेटली यू विल रिमेम्बर फॉर योर लाइफ टाइम. ओके, हियर द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट, फाइंड द रिवर नर्मदा ऑन मैप 1. सो वेयर इज रिवर नर्मदा? As you can see here, this is the Narmada River. Can you see this line? So this is the place of Narmada River. Okay, so this is the place the people started living. Now let me study here. People had lived along the banks of this river for several hundred thousand years. Okay, in the banks of this river, people started living for several thousand years. बहुत सारे साल उधर पे गुजारे हैं लोग. Okay. Some of the earliest people who lived here were skilled gatherers. It means the people who have started living earliest, means in the beginning of the history, if you take, okay, the people started living in this place, they were very skilled gatherers. That is people who gathered their food. Definitely, if they want to fill their stomach, if they want to eat something, they were food gatherers during the time. The work itself of them is, what was the job of those people? Only to gather the food. Us time ke jo log the, उनका काम ही बस यही था कि वो फूड की तलाश में, खाने की तलाश में वो गुजरते थे. ओके, बस उनका काम यही था कि खाना ढूंढना और खाना. दैट्स इट, राइट? द पीपल हु गैदर्ड देयर फूड आर कॉल्ड एज फूड गैदरर्स. दे वर बट दे वर वेरी स्किल्ड गैदरर्स. दे न्यू अबाउट द वास्ट वेल्थ ऑफ प्लांट्स इन द सराउंडिंग फॉरेस्ट एंड कलेक्टेड रूट्स, फ्रूट्स एंड अदर फॉरेस्ट प्रोड्यूस फॉर देयर फूड. एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट दे आर स्किल्ड. Can you remember the meaning of skilled is what? It's nothing but they are very intelligent. So why did they choose that particular place? Maybe the question can arise like this: why the people started living for so many years in the bank of river Narmada? What there were some other places was also there, right? बहुत सारी जगहें थे, उधर भी वो रहते रह सकते थे, लेकिन फिर भी वो क्यों इस जगह की तलाश में आए और इस जगह पे वो रहने लगे, राइट? बिकॉज दैट प्लेस इज फॉन्ड ऑफ वास्ट वेल्थ ऑफ प्लांट्स. ओके, बहुत सारे प्लांट्स थे और डेफिनेटली यू कैन सी वो जो रीजन है तो फॉरेस्ट एरिया से कवर्ड है, जिधर पे उनको फ्रूट्स मिल सकता है और जो भी रॉ मटेरियल चाहिए हर चीज उधर पे उनको मिल रहा था. ओके, एंड ऑल्सो दे हंटेड एनिमल्स. डेफिनेटली इफ देयर इज अ एरिया फॉरेस्ट, डेफिनेटली द एनिमल्स विल बी स्टेइंग इन दैट रीजन. They used to hunt the animals and they used to collect the roots, fruits, all those things, and they are going to use them as their respective food. right? Now let me find the Suleiman and Kirtar hill. So now we have got to know one thing. What was it? एक चीज हमारे को अभी जस्ट मिला है, क्या था वो? कि वो लोग कहां पे रहते थे, right? So first they were started living near Narmada. Please make a key point of this. Make a key point. The people have lived for several thousand years in the banks of river Narmada. Next, the Suleiman and Kirtar hills to the northwest. Can you see here northwest where it is? Yes, this is the region. This is the north and this is called as west. Your left hand side is west and right hand side is east. As you can see here, Suleiman. Can you see this? So this is the region of hilly region, Suleiman and Kirtar hill. Can you see this? This is Kirtar hill. This is the region of Kirtar hill and this is the region of Suleiman. Okay. This Suleiman and Kirtar hills to the northwest. Some of the areas were women and men first began to grow crops such as wheat and barley about 8,000 years ago are located here. So children, as the trend goes on, as the years goes on, जैसा जैसा वक्त बीतता गया, जैसा जैसा वक्त चलता गया, तो लोग क्या हुए? Well trained होते गए, technology बढ़ती गई उनमें भी, right? So people started growing, they learned about cultivation, they learned what? About cultivation thing they have learned. So the very beginning, the people started cultivation in this region. Can you tell me which is the region the people started cultivating the crop? That is Suleiman and Kirtar Hills region. So this is the region which is very fond of peculiar to grow the crop. So they started growing, all the men and women, they started growing, that is the crops such as wheat and barley. So wheat and barley was the early crop they started growing about 8,000 years ago. So this is the place which is located. People also began rearing animals. See children, how the technology started growing. And later on, they got to know the picture, they got to know the concept, how to rear the animals. They started rearing the animals like sheep, goat and cattle and lived in villages. Now they made a small territory, they started living in a small group, those are called as villages. Okay, they started rearing the animals, they started cultivating the crops, so and so. Now, locate the Garo hills. Next topic is locate the Garo hills to the northeast. Can you see here? Locate the Garo hills in the northeast. Yes, this is the north and this is the east. So can you see here? This is the region of Garo hills. Can you see here? Yes. So this is Garo hills. Okay. Locate the map Garo hills to the northeast and Vindhyas in the central India. Vindhyas. Can you see here? This is the region. It's called as central India. Central is nothing but central. As you can see here, Garo hills to the northeast and Vindhyas in the central India. That is Garo hills in the northeast and Vindhyas. Can you see here above the Narmada river? Yes, this is the region Vindhyas. Okay. So what happened in this place? Let me see. There were some other areas where agriculture developed. So in this place, the agriculture started developing. The places where rice was first grown are to the north of the Vindhyas. So this is important name. Okay, so Vindhyas is the place. Okay, the rice was started growing and Garo hills is the place where agriculture started developed. Next, trace the river Indus and its tributaries. As you can see here, you can trace the river Indus. Can you check where is Indus river? Yes, can you see here? Yes, Indus river and their tributaries. So these are the tributaries of Indus river. Okay, so as you can see here, tributaries are nothing but small rivers that flow into a larger river. What is the meaning of tributaries? Tributaries are nothing but the small rivers that will come and flow into a larger river, that is called as tributaries. Okay. About 4,700 years ago, some of the earliest cities flourished on the banks of these rivers. About 4,700 years ago, what happened children? The earliest cities flourished on the banks of these rivers. Means new cities starting developed. Okay. बहुत से नए नए सिटीज डेवलप होना शुरू हो गए. लेटर अबाउट 2500 ईयर्स अगो सिटीज डेवलप्ड ऑन द बैंक्स ऑफ द गंगा एंड इट्स ट्रिब्यूटरीज एंड आल्सो द सी कोस्ट. अराउंड 2500 ईयर्स अगो इवन द सिटीज स्टार्टिंग डेवलप ऑन द बैंक्स ऑफ रिवर गंगा एंड देयर ट्रिब्यूटरीज एंड आल्सो अलोंग द सी कोस्ट. नाउ एज यू कैन सी वेयर इज रिवर गंगा इन दिस. कैन यू आइडेंटिफाई वेयर इज रिवर गंगा इन दिस? यस, दिस इज रिवर गंगा. Understood? So this is river Ganga, this is Indus river. Can you remember? This is Indus river and this is Narmada river. This is Narmada, this is Ganga river. Okay. As the name comes, you started learning each and every rivers. Okay, no need to get confused how to remember so many names, no children. As the things repeats every time, you will be very peculiar and very familiar with those names. No need to worry. So this is the region where the Ganga river flows. Okay. Now as you can see here, about 2500 years ago, cities developed on the banks of the Ganga and its tributaries and along the sea coast. Now locate the Ganga and its tributaries called the Sun. So remember, this is the new name which we are just coming to know. Locate the Ganga and its tributaries. So Ganga river and the tributaries of river Ganga are called as Sun. Sun, S-O-N, Sun. In ancient times, the river Ganga, these rivers to the south of the Ganga was known as Magadha. Okay, can you see the name? Magadha. Okay, now we have got to know one new name which is called as Magadha. We will be discussing everything step by step. No need to worry. In ancient times, the area along these rivers to the south of the Ganga was known as Magadha. So that particular region was known as Magadha. Now lying in the state of Bihar. Now where this Magadha region is lying? In the state of Bihar. Its rulers were very powerful and set up a large kingdom. So this Magadha became an emperor. Okay. So this Magadha emperor, this Magadha kingdom, okay, this it has become a very large kingdom. This place, this territory, this region become a very large kingdom. Kingdoms were set up in other parts of the country as well. So this Magadha emperor flourished even in different parts of our country. Throughout, people traveled from one part of the subcontinent to the another. Okay, the people started traveling from one continent to other continent, other subcontinent. Okay, next, the hills and high mountains including the Himalayas, deserts, rivers and seas made journeys dangerous at times, but never impossible. As you can see, the people were traveling from one place to another place. How was this journey? There was no transportation like bus, train, aeroplane or so and so. But people need to travel through deserts or through the rivers and the sea coast. Okay, but it was so dangerous, but still it is nothing like impossible. They were traveling by using these means. So men and women moved in search of livelihood as also to escape from natural disasters like floods or droughts. As you can see, the people actually they have to shift their places oftenly because of the natural disasters, because the people will get to know what the calamities can happen, and also they were in the search of their livelihood, that is in the search of the food. Okay, here two things are there. The people need to travel from one place to another place because of the reason, because of their livelihood, because of the food, and also to escape through natural calamities, that is natural disasters. Okay, इसीलिए लोग एक जगह से दूसरी जगह को वो shift होते रहे थे. Next, sometimes men marched in armies. Sometimes men marched in armies, conquering others' lands. So some men, what they did, they joined the kingdom. They joined into the kingdom, and that is called as armies. They marched in armies, and they were helping for the kings to conquer the land. They were helping for the territory regions, okay, to conquer the land. Means they are making a small group that is called as an army, and they were attacking others, and they were conquering the land. Still kings have not come into the picture here, okay, but I just gave an example like a king. Okay, is this clear? Some people, what they do, they make an army, and then they will attack on others to either conquer their food or conquer the land. Besides, merchants traveled with caravans or ships. So merchants means the people who come to buy or sell the goods, we call them as merchants. Okay, जो भी लोग बाहर से आते थे खरीदने के लिए या कुछ बेचने के लिए, हम उनको merchants बोलते हैं. So merchants traveled with caravans. Okay, like you may have seen, no? Like on the caravans का मतलब जैसे कि एक ऊंट के ऊपर बहुत सारा सामान लेकर आना. Okay, that is caravans. Okay, so merchants traveled with caravans or ships carrying valuable goods from place to place. Okay, and religious teachers walked from villages to village. town to town, stopping to offer instruction and advice on the way. Some religious teachers were there, even they were also moving. The merchants also, we can see they are moving from one place to another place to sell their goods or to buy the goods. Okay, and also the religious teachers also moving from village to village, town to town, to advise, okay, to offer the instruction. Finally, some people perhaps traveled driven by spirit of adventure, wanting to discover new and exciting places. All this led to the sharing of ideas between people. As we can see, the people in different ways, they are moving from one place to another place. Some want to discover new things, some want to sell something, some want to advise something. In this way, the people started moving from one place to another place and they were sharing their ideas. Now you can see here, as the people move from one place to another place, definitely their ideas will also get shared up. Correct. Next, why do people travel nowadays? Now why we have to travel, Simran? What is the reason we are traveling nowadays? Now we can see here into this picture. Look at map one once more. Hills, mountains and seas from the natural frontiers of the subcontinent, while it was difficult to cross these frontiers, those who wanted could and did scale the mountains and cross the seas. As you can see here, you can see in this map one, this is the map one. As you can see, there are so many mountains are there, so many rivers are there, right? As you can see, and the ocean also you can see, okay? As you can see the map, okay? Now come to this point. Now we have seen the hills, we have seen the mountains, and also we have seen the seas. So they form the natural frontiers of the subcontinent. Means those are the main territories, those are the main gates, let me say called as a gates. Okay, the people started moving from one place to another place, then they have to cross those areas. They need to cross those subcontinents. And also it was difficult to cross these frontiers. Those who wanted could and did scale the mountains and cross the seas. As you can see, there were so many big oceans was there, so many big rivers was there and hills was there. It's not so easy as due to the climatic condition, right, geographical condition. It's not so easy that they can cross those areas. Sometimes the people, what they do, okay, they used to use the other path, like they used to take the scale of the mountains and they are going to cross the seas. Got it? Now people from across the frontiers also came into the subcontinent and settled here. And other people from the other zone, they used to come into this region. Okay, from this region they used to come to the another region and they started settling over there. These movements of people enriched our cultural traditions. People have shared new ways of carving stone, composing music and even cooking food, and several hundreds of years. So as you can see, as the people started settling down, actually they lived in some place and they are settling in some other place. Due to this, what happened? The tradition began, right? So different cultural traditions began, and also they started learning new activities. जिस तरह से वो एक जगह से दूसरी जगह को पहुंचते रहे या दूसरी जगह में वो रहने के लिए शुरू कर दिए, तो क्या किए, तो वो बहुत सारे नए नए चीज को डिस्कवर करना शुरू कर दिए. ओके, नाउ एज यू कैन सी नेम्स ऑफ द लैंड, टू ऑफ द वर्ड्स वी ऑफन यूज फॉर आवर कंट्री आर इंडिया एंड भारत. रिमेम्बर दिस, एक्चुअली दिस इज द टू वर्ड्स यूजुअली वी यूज, स्टिल समवेयर वी यूज टू यूज दिस वर्ड इंडिया एंड भारत. द वर्ड इंडिया कम्स फ्रॉम द इंडस कॉल्ड सिंधु इन संस्कृत. वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फॉर क्लास सिक्स ग्रेड स्टूडेंट्स. Our country has two names. Which are the two names of our country? India and Bharat. So from where the India word comes? Can you tell me? From, please make a note of this word. Where the India word came? It came from the word Indus. Okay? Called Sindhu. What we call it as? Sindhu River. Okay? Indus, that is Sindhu in Sanskrit. We called Sindhu in Sanskrit. Find Iran and Greece in your atlas. Okay, as you can open your atlas, I want, must and should, it's compulsory that your school atlas you need to have with you whenever you are studying your social science. You can just check where is Iran and Greece in your atlas. Now, the Iranians and the Greeks who came through the northwest about 2500 years ago and were familiar with the Indus called it the Hindus, or the Indore, and the land to the east of the river called India. As you can see, children, the Iran and Greece. Okay, now Iranians and the Greeks. Okay, the one who is staying in Iran, that is Iranian. In Greece, those are called as Greeks. Okay, ये दो लोग क्या किए? इनको बहुत जगह के बारे में, वो मतलब कि उस जगह के अंदर उनको बहुत मालूमात थी उस जगह के बारे में. As you can see here, the Iranians and the Greeks who came through the northwest. From where, from which region they came? From the northwest. Like example, this is the north, and this is the east, and left side is the west. They came from the northwest region. This region, okay. And they were very familiar with the place of Indus. Okay, they know the geographical conditions of the place Indus. Those people, they used to call this Indus region as Hindus. They used to call this region as Hindus or the Indus. Okay, and the land to the east, and the land to the east of the river was called as India. Okay, the land towards east, right side is called as India, and left side is called as Hindus. Okay. The name Bharata was used for a group of people who lived in the northwest. The people who started living in the northwest, that is left side. Okay, so those people are mentioned. Okay, those people usually we used to call them as Bharata. Is it clear? The name Bharata was used for the people, the group of people who lived in northwest region. We used to call them as Bharata, and who are mentioned in the Rig Veda. This name is already come in Rig Veda. The earliest composition in Sanskrit dated to about 3500 years ago. Later it was used for the country. Okay, so actually this word has come from the Sanskrit 300-500 years ago, and later on we were using this name for our country. Finding out about the past. Now we want to know what actually happened in the past, right? So what are the evidences are there? How you can tell that this was my past, this happened during the time? As you can see here, a page from a palm leaf is called as manuscript. Children, before going to this, let me just have even a look into this picture. Okay, because we need to cover each and everything. As you can see, a passing page, this is a map of South Asia. This is a map of South Asia, the map what we are seeing here. This is a physical map of the subcontinent. Okay, South Asia, including the present countries of India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Nepal, Bhutan and Sri Lanka, and the neighboring countries of Afghanistan, Iran, China and Myanmar. South Asia is often called a subcontinent. South Asia, we used to call them as subcontinent, because although it is smaller than a continent, so we call it as subcontinent, but it is very large and is separated from the rest of Asia by seas, hills and mountains. As you can see, why we have given the word subcontinent, because it is very large and it is also separated from the rest of Asia. Okay, seas, hills and mountains. Now as you can see here, a page from a palm leaf is called as manuscript. This manuscript was written about 1000 years ago. The palm leaves were cut into pages and tied together to make a book. To see a birch bark manuscript, let me study later on. I'll tell you about this. Just I have read this information. Let me see here what exactly the thing meant by. Okay, there are several ways of finding out about the past. So one is to search for and read books, right? If you want to know about the past, what we do? We search the information by reading the books, which was written long years ago. These are called as manuscripts. Okay, writing the information into the book is called as manuscript. Remember, manuscript ka matlab kya hai? Ki hum ek information ko likhe, hum usko rakhein. और जो लिखा है उस वक्त में, उस जमाने में, ड्यूरिंग दोज ईयर्स द पीपल यूज टू राइट. ओके, दोज रिटन इंफॉर्मेशन इज कॉल्ड एज मैनुस्क्रिप्ट. वेयर एक्चुअली दे वर राइटिंग ऑन ए पाम लीफ. यस, नो, यू कैन सी दिस इंफॉर्मेशन. दे यूज टू राइट द इंफॉर्मेशन ऑन ए पाम लीफ. ओके, नाउ एज यू कैन सी दिस आर कॉल्ड एज मैनुस्क्रिप्ट बिकॉज दे वर रिटन बाय हैंड. दे यूज टू यूज their hand to write this information. This come from the Latin word manu, meaning hand. Manu means hand. Script means information. That is called as manuscript. Okay, by using the hand, they used to write the information. They used to write the scripts. So that we call them as manuscripts. These were usually written on a palm leaf or on the specially prepared bark of a tree known as a birch, which grows in the Himalayas. So sometimes they used to use palm leaf, and sometimes they used to use the bark of a tree, which is grown in the region Himalaya. Over the years, manuscripts were eaten away by insects. As you can see, it was written from the palm leaf. So as the days goes on, some insects, what they did, they have torn those information. Okay, many manuscripts were eaten away by insects. Some were destroyed, but many have survived. As you can see, some information has destroyed, but still some information is left out. Often preserved in temples and monasteries. Okay, there is a secret places. Usually these all manuscripts are usually preserved in these places. Okay, because those were the important documents. इसके लिए जो important documents थे, manuscripts थे, उनको बहुत अच्छी जगह पे, जैसे कि temples और monasteries जो थे, उस जगह पे, okay, lockers हम बोलते हैं ना, हाँ, उस जगह पे, हाँ, उसको रखा गया था. तो इसके लिए आज थोड़े वो बहुत हमारे को मिल रहे हैं. इससे हम जान सकते हैं कि पहले क्या हुआ था, कैसा था, हर चीज हमारे को जानने के लिए इंफॉर्मेशन मिल रहा है. सो दिस बुक्स डेल्ट विद ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ सब्जेक्ट्स. ओके, इन दिस मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट दिस बुक डेल्ट विद ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ सब्जेक्ट्स, रिलीजियस बिलीफ एंड प्रैक्टिसेस. ड्यूरिंग द टाइम व्हाट वाज द रिलीजियस, व्हाट वाज द रिलीजन, व्हाट वाज देयर बिलीफ, व्हाट प्रैक्टिसेस दे यूज्ड टू डू, द लाइव्स ऑफ किंग्स, मेडिसिन एंड साइंस. बिसाइड्स देयर वर एपिक्स, पोएम्स, प्लेस. मेनी ऑफ दीज वर रिटन इन संस्कृत. As you can see, this all information is written in Sanskrit. Others were in Prakrit. Okay. Others were in Prakrit, languages used by ordinary people, and Tamil. So this was actual languages what we can see the information. Okay. The manuscripts were there in these all languages. Some were there in Sanskrit. Some were there in Prakrit. That is called as the ordinary language of those people. Prakrit. One is Sanskrit. Next is Prakrit. And the third one is Tamil. So these were the usual languages which was used in early time, in those days. We can also study inscriptions. Children, these two words are very, very important for your examination point of view. They may ask you the concept called as what are manuscripts or what are inscriptions. And also they may ask you to write the difference between manuscripts and inscriptions. Now as you can see here, inscriptions, these are writings. Even this is also written history. Manuscripts is also written history. Inscription is also written history. But what is the major difference? Let me see here. These are writings on relatively hard surfaces such as stone or metal. Okay, if they want to write this inscription, they used to use the hard metal, hard stone. On those stones, they used to write the information. So we call them as inscriptions. Okay, वो क्या करते थे? पहाड़ के पत्थरों के ऊपर या कोई मेटल के ऊपर, इस टाइप के ऑर्नामेंट्स के ऊपर वो इंफॉर्मेशन को लिखाया जाता था उस टाइम पे लिखे थे. तो इसके लिए हम उनको क्या बोलते हैं? इंस्क्रिप्शन. अगर से वो पाम लीफ के ऊपर इंफॉर्मेशन लिख रहे हैं तो मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट. इफ दे आर यूजिंग एनी हार्ड सरफेस देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज इंस्क्रिप्शन. समटाइम्स किंग्स गॉट देयर ऑर्डर्स इंस्क्राइब्ड सो दैट पीपल कुड सी रेड एंड ओबे देम. ओके, सो पीपल, इफ द किंग्स हैज टू ऑर्डर समथिंग, they used to use this type of technique to pass the information. Okay, as the information is written on the stone so that every people can see those information. There are other kinds of inscriptions as well, where men and women, including kings and queens, recorded what they did. As you can see, some kings and queens were there, whatever they want to do or what happened, they used to write that information. They used to ask, they used to order for their employees, okay, the servants who are there in the kingdom, to write the information. As they speak, they used to write that. For example, kings often kept records of victories in battle. So which battle they won. So this kind of important memories they want to store. So that they used to write on those metal or hard surfaces. Can you think of the advantages of writing on a hard surface? Why they want to use hard surface? Why can't they use palm leaf only? Right? This is a question. So what is the advantage of writing on a hard surface? And what could have been the difficulties? उसके ऊपर लिखने में क्या difficulties face करना पड़ रहा था उस time पे? There were many other kings. There were many other things that were made and used in the past. Those who study these objects are called as archaeologists. So archaeologists were the one who used to study the information which is written on those hard surfaces. So what they do, they collect the information, they collect those type of objects, any hard surfaces, stones or any kind of different stones or metals, they used to collect it and they used to identify the information what is written on that. So those people are called as archaeologists. Okay, so who are the archaeologists? The archaeologists are nothing but the one who study about the old objects. Okay, the one who study about the old objects are called as archaeologists. They study the remains of the buildings made of stone and brick, paintings and sculpture. What they study? They study the remains of building. During that time, maybe the buildings have completely destroyed, but still some part of the building is remained. That is called as remains of the building. So made of stone and brick, paintings and sculpture, they also explore and excavate. Excavate is nothing but they used to dig the earth surface. Okay. वो जमीन को खोदते थे. खोदने के बाद में उनको कुछ पेंटिंग्स मिलते थे, आइडल्स मिलते थे, स्कल्पचर्स मिलते थे, पेंटिंग्स मिलते थे, उसको भी वो स्टडी करते गए. ओके, सो आर्कियोलॉजिस्ट व्हाट दे डू, दे स्टार्टेड एक्सप्लोरिंग एंड एक्सकवेट टू फाइंड टूल्स, वेपन्स, पॉट्स, पैन्स, ऑर्नामेंट्स एंड कॉइन्स. सम ऑफ दीज ऑब्जेक्ट्स मे बी मेड ऑफ स्टोन, अदर्स ऑफ बोन, बेक्ड क्ले और मेटल. एज दे स्टार्टेड एक्सकवेटिंग एंड दे वर स्टार्टेड सर्चिंग दोज ऑब्जेक्ट्स, what they were getting some things which is made up of stone or something which is of bone, others of bone. Okay, maybe the people who have died at that time, they were just buried in the same condition. As you can see, they used to collect that bone and they can identify in which period maybe these people belongs to. Okay, they used to collect the information through the bone. Okay, baked clay or metal, objects that are made of hard imperishable substances usually survive for a long time, right? The things and the objects were very hard. Definitely, it's very difficult. Those objects can change their shape. Okay, so that today it is one of the advantage, so that those objects are still alive. Those objects still give the information since they were very hard. Now, as you can see on the left, a pot from an old city. So this was the remains which was collected from the archaeologist. Okay, a pot from an old city. Pots like this were used about 4700 years ago. Right side you can see, in the right side we can see a silver coin. Coins such as this one were in use from about 2500 years ago. As you can see here on the right side, there is a silver coin. Coins such as this one were used from about 2500 years ago. Now the question is, in what ways is the coin different from the others we use today? Archaeologists also look for bones of animals, birds and fish to find out what people ate in the past. Okay, so archaeologists, what they do, they used to collect the bones of all the animals, birds and fish. From there they started collecting the information about the past. Plant remains survive far more rarely if seeds of grains or pieces of wood have been burnt. So plants remain survive far more rarely. So we can collect this information through the plants is very less due to maybe those seeds or grains or the pieces of wood might have been burnt. So they survive in a charred form. Do you think cloth is found frequently by archaeologists? Okay, as you can see the question, do you think cloth is found frequently by archaeologists? As we can see here, historians, that is scholars who study the past, often use the word source to refer to the information found from manuscripts, inscriptions and archaeology. Historians are the scholars who study about the past. What they did, they used to collect the information from the manuscripts, inscriptions and also through archaeology. Once sources are found, learning about the past becomes an adventure. When sources are found, learning about the past becomes an adventure. Is this clear? as we reconstruct it bit by bit. So as the information we have collected, जिस तरह से हम information मिला, हम उसको फिर दोबारा उसको फिर renovate करते गए, reconstruct करते गए. So historians and archaeologists are like detectives. So we call historians and archaeologists like detectives who use all these sources like clues to find out about our past. Next, one past or many. Did you notice the title of this book, Our Past? We have used the word past in plural to draw attention to the fact that his past was different from different groups of people. For example, the lives of herders or farmers were different from those kings and queens, right? As you can see, as the people during the time, okay, how the people were staying in one region, similarly in the other region, the people's their habit, the habitat, okay, everything was different. Is this clear? So the lives of the merchants were different from those of the craftsmen, and so on. Also, as it true even today, people followed different practices and customs in different parts. Also, as it true even today, people followed different practices and customs in different parts of the country. For example, today most people living in the Andaman Islands get their own food by fishing, hunting and collecting forest produce. By contrast, most people living in cities depend on others for supplies of food. As you can see, even now also the present stage, the people who are staying in Andaman Islands, jo bhi log Andaman Islands ke paas hai, unko kya hai? Unko direct mil raha hai. Jaise ki wo fishing, hunting ya collecting, jo forest ka jo produce hai, usko istemal karke wo jee rahe hain. Right? इसी तरह से जो पीपल अर्बन सिटीज में हैं, तो वो देख सकते हैं कि आप वो दूसरे फूड प्रोडक्ट के लिए डिपेंड हो रहे हैं किसी और के ऊपर. करेक्ट. सो डिफरेंस सच एज दिस एग्जिस्टेड इन द पास्ट एज वेल. सो इवन ड्यूरिंग द टाइम आल्सो इन सम रीजन द पीपल्स वर गेटिंग देयर फूड डायरेक्टली एंड सम पीपल्स दे वॉन्ट टू गेट द फूड ओके बाय द अदर्स. दे आर डिपेंडिंग ऑन अदर्स. ओके. बिसाइड देयर इज अनदर काइंड ऑफ डिफरेंस. We know a great deal about kings and the battles they fought because they kept records of their victories. Today still we can able to identify what happened during the time because of these records. Usually I have said you that earlier, the people, the kings and the queens, whatever the battles or whatever the good things they used to do or whatever the things they are very appreciable, okay, those kind of information they used to write it on the hard surfaces. So that today those remains are very helpful for us to identify about the past. Generally, ordinary people such as hunters, fishing folk, gatherers, farmers or herders did not keep records of what they did. Okay, while archaeology helps us to find about their lives, there is much that remains unknown. Okay, so archaeologists are finding difficulty to identify the records of these people, but about the kings, it's very easy to collect the information, but about the ordinary people, how was their livelihood, is quite difficult to identify their records. But it is not impossible. Okay? What do dates mean? Can you see this word? Dates. What does it mean? If somebody asks you the date, you'll probably mention the day, month and year. Of course. Am I right? Yes. 2000 and something. These years are counted from the date generally assigned to the birth of Jesus Christ. Now the date here, what we mention here, this is as per the date of Jesus Christ, the founder of Christianity. Okay, from this is the basic, this is our zero line. From here we consider this is zero line and we consider the date. Okay, so 2000 means 2000 years after the birth of Christ. That is the meaning of that. Okay, 2000 years after the birth of Christ, all dates before the birth of Christ are counted backwards and usually have the letters BC, before Christ. As you can see this word BC, BC means before Christ. The dates we are considering before the birth of Jesus Christ, that is BC. Added on, in this book we will refer to dates going back from the present. First we come from the back and then we come to the present. So using 2000 as our starting point. Let me consider 2000 as the starting point and let me consider the dates. Okay, so I hope you have understood. So BC we have seen, that is stand for before Christ. You will sometimes find AD, means before dates. Okay, AD, can you see the word AD? This stands for two Latin words, Anno Domini, Anno Domini, meaning in the year of the Lord. So 2012 can be written as AD 2012. Okay, Anno Domini means after, before Christ is BC. Next is AD. Okay, sometimes CE is used instead of AD. Sometimes we use CE also instead of AD and BCE instead of BC. The letter CE stands for Common Era and BCE before Common Era. Again, you can see this is before and this is after. We use these terms because the Christian era is now used in most countries of the world. In India, we began using this form of dating from about 200 years ago. This technology, this concept we are using around 200 years ago. And sometimes the letters BP, meaning before present, are used. Find two dates mentioned on page 3 with set of letters which would use for them. Now you can see elsewhere we have seen that inscriptions are inscribed on hard surfaces. So these are the inscriptions which has been inscribed on the hard surfaces. Many of these were inscribed several hundred years of ago. Okay. All inscriptions contain both scripts and languages. As you can see, both scripts are there and even some languages are there. Languages which are used as well as scripts have changed over time. So how do scholars understand what was inscribed? This can be done through a process called as decipherment. Very important. Okay, now I want to understand what exactly this means. Right, I need to understand, right? Hamare ko pata chalna hai ki ye figure ka matlab kya hai, ye language kya hai, kaun si language hai, ye kya likha gaya hai, hum isko janna hai. To wo process ko hum bolte hain, is tarike ko janne ke liye hum usko kya bolte hain, decipherment. जैसा जैसा सालें गुजरते गए, जैसा जैसा ईयर्स खत्म होते गए, जैसा जैसे नए साल आते गए, नए ओके हाउ द थिंग्स हैव चेंज. ओके, सो दैट्स द रीजन इवन द लैंग्वेज इज ऑल्सो चेंज, बट स्टिल दिस वर द रिमेन्स स्टिल दे आर हियर. ओके, टू स्टडी एंड टू आइडेंटिफाई वॉट एग्जैक्टली दिस मीन्स, दिस इज डन बाय द प्रोसेस कॉल्ड एज डिसिपरमेंट. डिसिपरमेंट, वन ऑफ द मोस्ट फेमस स्टोरीज ऑफ डिसिपरमेंट कम्स फ्रॉम इजिप्ट. Okay, so this famous stories come from the place Egypt, a country in North Africa where there were kings and queens about 5000 years ago. Right, so Rosetta is a town on the north coast of Egypt. What is the name of that coast? What is the name of that place? Rosetta. So Rosetta is a town on the north coast of Egypt, and here an inscribed stone was found which contained inscriptions in three different languages and scripts, ग्रीक एंड टू फॉर्म्स ऑफ इजिप्टियन. तो रोसेटा एक टाउन है. ओके, इधर पे एक हमारे को स्टोन मिला जो इंस्क्राइब स्टोन था, उसके ऊपर कुछ लैंग्वेजेस लिखे थे. जैसे कि आप देख सकते हैं उसके ऊपर तीन डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस से लिखा गया है, एंड स्क्रिप्ट दैट इज ग्रीक एंड टू फॉर्म्स ऑफ इजिप्टियन. स्कॉलर्स हु कुड रीड ग्रीक फिगर्ड आउट दैट द नेम्स ऑफ द किंग्स एंड क्वींस वर इंक्लूज इन ए लिटिल फ्रेम कॉल्ड ए कार्टोचे. रिमेंबर, in Egypt, some kings and queens, what they did in a little frame, in a small frame, what they did, they have written their names. That is called as cartouche. They then placed the Greek and Egyptian signs side by side and identified the sounds for which the Egyptian letters stood. So which type of languages they were using during that time, even that also symbol they have written side by side. Okay, as you can see, they have placed Greek and Egyptian signs side by side and identify the sound for which the Egyptian letters stood. As you can see, a lion stood for L and a bird for A. Once they knew what the letters stood for, they could read other inscription as well. So this technique was helped them to identify. Sometimes if some people want to send their inscription to these people, they need to identify, right? So these letters were easy for them to identify. L means lion. Lion is nothing but, and bird means A. Means some people using this bird symbol as their logo, and some people using lion symbol as their logo. And to remember, they used to write L, so it was easily understandable. Yes, this is Greek. A, example I'm telling. Yes, this is from Egypt. Okay. Once they knew this letter stood for, then it will be easy for them to identify, okay, the information from where this information has brought or from where this information we have collected. So as you can see here, these are the questions. Let me recall, match the following: Narmada Valley, Magadha, Garo Hills, Indus and its tributaries, Ganga Valley. So you need to match this. Narmada Valley, the first big kingdom, is it right? Hunting and gathering, cities about 2500 years ago, early agriculture, the first city. So you need to identify Narmada Valley matches to what? Magadha is what? Magadha, as the word itself says that, it is a kingdom. So it's the first kingdom. Garo Hills, just we have studied. Garo Hills and what we say is that central, Vidhana. Okay, Garo Hills and that is Vidya, sorry. So Garo Hills and Vidyas. So what was their famous for? As you can see, Garo Hills is the place where the first agriculture started, correct? No, Garo Hills or Vindhyas? Yes, Garo Hills is the place and the agriculture was developed, and the north of Vindhyas rice was first discovered, correct? No. And next, Narmada Valley, the people started living in this place earlier, right? So this was the cities about 2500 years ago. Indus and its tributaries and Ganga Valley. You need to identify this, match the following. And here, next question, list one major difference between manuscripts and inscriptions. Just now we have discussed. Can you tell what Rashida wants to answer? Can you return to Rashida's question? Can you think of some answers to it? Yes, of course. Make a list of all objects that archaeologists may find. What are the things archaeologists who I have found? And my dear UPSC candidates, the one who want to study, my dear friends, the UPSC candidates, you no need to collect this all information kind of a thing, because UPSC never ask any facts. Just they will ask you what happened exactly and also what you can do it from that. Okay, these are the only things the information will be asked for the UPSC aspirants, the one who wants to enter for civil services. For those people I am telling, okay, you no need to collect the information or something like that. And why do you think ordinary men and women did not generally keep records or what they did? It is quite interesting question. Why these people didn't store their information? Why they have not maintained their records? Why only kings and queens have maintained their records? Why these people can't maintain the records? Can you collect some information regarding that? If it is so, it is be quite useful for you. Describe at least two ways in which you think the lives of kings would have been different from those of farmers. As you can see, the trend was changing, the territories were changing. So definitely the king's life and the peasant's life or the farmer's life was quite different. So you can tell in what way you can tell that both the lives were different. Now you can do this activity, so it will be very much helpful for class 6 grade students. I hope the concept is clear for you all. Wish you all the best of luck. In my next class, we will be going to start the chapter number 2. I hope this information is helpful for you all. Wish you all the best of luck. Still, if you are not subscribed to my YouTube channel, Shasar Classes, do subscribe it and click the bell icon. Wish you all the best of luck. Share this video as much as possible with your all friends. Keep watching to our YouTube channel. Take care. Comment below how was this class and what video you want to make me next. Take care.